By the way, have you seen Oscar De La Hoya's new segment he does every Thursday? It's called Clap Back Thursday. Why do you like it?
Because he's funny. I like everything he says. A lot of it, sometimes a lot of it is kind of, maybe not really correct, but it still, he makes it fun. It's fun. I like
He has a good sense of humor.
Yeah, it is.
Okay, so do you see the video of Eddie Hearn trying to mock him and copy him?
I love that shit.
What do you think? What did Eddie Hearn say?
Eddie came back pretty good, man. What is it? Fuck Off Friday? That's just badass. Fuck Off Friday. And he imitates him and fucking talks about, you know, him fucking...
Canelo left you.
Canelo left you. It's suing you. Fucking, what's his name? Munguia used to pretend...
Oh, he's with Topper.
Used to pretend to be in charge of Munguia when he signed with Top Rank.
Isn't he going back to Golden Boy in a couple
really
fights?
I don't know what's going on. See, that's why it's funny.
Yeah.
The actor said one thing and then he's saying the true opposite. I really don't know what it is.
But he did a pretty good imitation.
Yeah, it is pretty bad. It's nice.
That's funny.
It is nice.
But Oscar's Clapback Thursday is pretty creative.
Pretty popular.
Yeah?
It became pretty popular.
Listen, he's very famous. He has a good sense of humor. Yeah. He's having fun. If you have fun, people...
I thought he was gonna have like Clapback Thursday little segment on. I don't know if you've seen Victor Ortiz. There's an interview where he says that he went to spar Oscar, and Oscar, they gave him like pillow gloves so Victor could spar, and then a headgear with no protection, and Oscar had a bar and everything, and then he says that he dropped Oscar twice. So I don't know if it's true, because if Oscar didn't bring it up, that probably is true, because Victor had power. That fucker always hit very hard. So he probably did drop Oscar. That's why Oscar didn't even bring it up. But, you know, it was funny because everybody was expecting Oscar to bring it up to respond. If he didn't respond, it's because it might have happened.
Did you ever spar Victor?
No,
he was your fighter. No, but sometimes...
I spar him.
Wait, what if he's fighting a certain fighter with your size, your skills?
I never sparred my fighter.
Biggest name you ever sparred, famous.
I never sparred my fighter,
no,
bro.
Not your fighter. When you were a fighter. They brought you to spar Mayweather or...
I sparred Morales, Barrera. I sparred a lot of people. Gennaro Hernandez. I sparred a lot of people, man. I don't know who the biggest and most famous was.
Who was the nicest person?
Oscar was great when we had training camps together.
De La Hoya?
We did 3 years of training camps together. In 3 years, we were both getting started our careers. So when he won his first title at 130, I did training camp with him. So we did. And we were fighting often. So 3 years, say five fights. So we did like probably 15 training camps together. Great, man. It was awesome going bowling, going to the movies together, hanging out, eating together, playing pool together. We had great. So he was a great experience with Oscar.
Anyone you sparred that was not as nice, do you expect them to be cool because their image? But
I don't fucking remember, man.
But you were cool with everybody.
No, everybody was cool and sparring.
Okay, who hit the hardest of anyone you ever sparred?
Whoever got me the hardest was Gennaro Hernandez with the body shot. There was a body shot that he got me with that I swear to God, for a few minutes, I had to hold. I didn't go down. I had to hold. I couldn't fucking, like, my brain, everything fucking paralyzed, man, with that body shot that he landed. And it fucking took a few seconds for me to even recover, because it was fucking... It was a fucking
He placed
deadly,
it perfectly.
It was a deadly fucking body.
Like Virgil Ortiz did in his fight.
I didn't go down, bro. I didn't go down because I just did. I felt embarrassed, but I fucking hold. I think he noticed, paid it off because, you know, he didn't want to embarrass me.
You were 17, right? 18.
I was 16, 17 16. When I sparred him. Yeah.
Okay, who was the fastest hands you ever sparred? Oscar.
Probably Oscar, yeah. I sparred Oscar quite a few times. Never fought him in the amateurs. There's a video out there that we fought, but now I never fought
Who
him.
Who was the dirtiest fighter you ever sparred? That just hit below, behind the head, back, headbutts? Nobody?
Yeah, I don't remember. Shit.
Anybody talk trash to you when they sparred?
No. I don't remember a lot of that shit.
Good footwork?
Fucking
no.
30 years ago, bro.
Some stuff you don't forget, Robert.
Shit, man.
Diego Corrales, how good
I
was he?
I never sparred Diego Corrales.
How about
Casamayor? I sparred Casamayor too.
He's funny. I like Casamayor.
He's fucking fast.
He's like a Tasmanian devil.
Yeah.
He still wants to fight.
No, he doesn't. Fucking Eli, shut the fuck up.
You said Barrera. He was in his prime, right?
Barrera was in his prime. He was fighting for the title when I sparred him. He was getting ready to fight for the title.
He's a legend too, an icon.
I reminded him. He didn't remember that we sparred each other. Yeah. We did Un Round Mas. It should come out in the next few weeks or whatever. And
you reminded him?
I reminded him. He asked me about the gym, Caché Boxing Gym in LA. That's the place everybody went to.
Where was it?
In LA, no. Downtown LA. Joe Hernandez. It was a Joe Hernandez. Everybody used to go there. And he says, "Did you ever go there?" I'm like, "Yeah, we sparred each other right there." I spar Morales in that gym too.
Eric? Who's harder to spar? Herrera or Morales? I think between
both of them, because I only sparred him once each, Barrera was.
But in one sparring, you don't know.
There was only one sparring, yeah. You know who's the only one that has ever reminded me about that sparring? Me and my dad, we know, yeah. We were there. But the only one that reminded me a few months ago when I went to visit him in Tijuana was Fernando Beltran.
Wow.
Fernando Beltran tells me, this is fucking, I was probably like 16 or 17. So we're talking about 32 years ago. I'm fucking 49, so yeah. So he reminded me, and he's like, "Robert, I was there when you sparred Morales." I'm like, "Fucking shit, you were there." He's like, "Yeah, I remember the sparring."
He's been in sport for many years.
Ask him whenever you get a chance.
I will.
I don't bring it up. I don't need to bring it up. It was sparring. A lot of things happen in sparring. A lot of fighters.
You dropped them?
It doesn't matter. Because in the fight, look at him. He became a fucking legend. He became a 4-division champion. You know, so sparring doesn't mean shit. But
you can say you shared the ring with
him. But I did share the ring with him. And with Barrera too. And Beltran is the only one that has brought up that sparring. He's like, "I remember, I was there."
Okay, fuck, hold on. Robert. If I go ask the Big G right now, what happened to sparring?
Don't ask him. Please don't ask him.
Why? Because he's gonna be too honest?
He's gonna say too much and maybe exaggerate a little. Because fuck, 30 some years ago, my dad won't remember that much either. He'll probably say a little more than what really happened.
But it was great.
But it was great fun.
Hey, Sugar Cane did good today. He sparred Oscar Duarte. Like, you know what's funny? Today's the first time he's been serious since I ever met him. Usually he jokes a lot. He wasn't joking today.
He sparred Jose the other day. Really good too, man.
No.
I know he's a little out of shape. That's why he got tired with Jose. But that fucker did. He's really good, man.
I've never seen him as serious as today.
I like him as a young kid. He's a good little kid.
Talks a lot of shit.
He's a good young prospect.
So there you have it, Robert. Message to your fans. What do you tell them?
What do I tell them? Keep an eye on Chop Chop.
Keep an eye on Chop Chop, on Bam, on Sugar Cane, and Duarte, Jose.
December 7th in Phoenix, Arizona.
December 7th, let's go. Arizona, how come you never fight in Moreno Valley?
Because Moreno Valley don't got no state, nothing for me.
What about in LA? Hey, you could do fights at your gym.
We're gonna know, but he's signed with Top Rank.
Okay, so why doesn't Top Rank do shows in LA?
They probably will soon for him. I'm telling you.
Maybe Ontario.
They have to do Ontario for a band.
Let's do Chop. Ontario, sell out this. What is it?
Yeah.
The Citizen Bank Arena has a new name
Toyota,
now.
The Toyota Center.
Yeah.
Yes, sir.
They do that one for Chop and Raymond too. Raymond and Chop right there, both together.
That'll be sick.
They'll sell that shit out.
They'll fucking pack that shit out.
Raymond and Chop right there. Top line. That'll do it.
I think that'll be good.
They got to think about it.
Yeah.
Have you met Bob Arum yet?
No, not yet.
You got to make that meeting.
Yeah, we have
Bob
to.
Bob would love him. Bob would love you.
Soon. I got to keep performing, you know? Yep. And keep, God willing, keep having good performances. And
yep.
He'll see, you know?
He'll know who you are. Chop Gonzalez, look out for him. Felipe is trying to call you out. He's trying to show his skills in the bag to say, "You don't want that smoke." What would happen if you guys fought? What do you think about that? He said he'll F you up.
Huh?
He said he'll fuck you up.
What you think, Ellie?
Hey, Sugar Cane, who wins? Let me ask. Johnny, who wins between him and Felipe in a fight?
Who's Felipe?
Who's Felipe? That answers the question
right there.
That
answers the question right there.
Felipe. The coach. Who wins in a fight? He asked me who's Felipe.
What?
Who wins between Felipe and Chop Chop?
Oh. Ellie, please don't ask those questions, Ellie.
You didn't answer.
You don't need to ask those questions.
What
would happen if we had a rubber fight?
Right now, look at
me. I like this fucker.
Yeah, it's crazy right here. I've been sparring for like 18.
So. You don't want to spar me, huh?
I don't want to spar
him. You don't want to spar him. I've seen what he does to people. Oh, Robin Hughes, one punch.
I never heard of Robin.
You know, he worked in construction. He knows how to build houses and everything.
I worked the union for a year.
That's good.
My dad was my foreman.
That's badass.
All metal stud framing.
All that.
Nah, you better off Foxy, huh? Nah, bro. You know that shit's hard.
The fiberglass, getting my skin every day.
In your eyes.
Yeah.